Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. The Yiddish people, the Yiddish nation, is singled out not only in how they behave, but perhaps even in their culture of what they eat. Obviously, what's kosher and what's not kosher, but even in the foods that are kosher and it's many other nations are able to eat it. Some of them we don't eat. It's not our culture to eat what Lahavdil the Goyim eat. And it's not the Goyish culture to eat what we eat. And with this, there is a fascinating Rashi in Parshas Vezoyse Bracha where Rashi says that this also shows the uniqueness, the specialty of Klal Yisrael. When it comes to the Bracha, that the Pasuk says about Zevulun, Zevulun doing business, and Zevulun was by the port. So Rashi says in Kapitel Lamed Gimel, Pasuk Yutes, Rashi says a very fascinating thing, that so many Goyim would do business with the tribe of Zevulun, and once they would come to by the port and do business, Heim Oimrim, they would say to themselves like this, Hayo v'nitztarinu ad kan, since we went through the bother to travel all the ways here to do the business with the Jews, Neilech al Yerushalayim, let's go up to Yerushalayim, v'nira, and let's see what's so special about the Jews. What's unique about them? Ma yirasa shel umazu. What is their God? What's their religion? Uma ma'aseh. How do they behave? V'heim ra'im, says Rashi. You know what they see? Kol Yisrael oivdim eloka echad. They see, very interesting, all Jews share the same God. Hashem elekeinu, Hashem echad. We all worship the same Hashem. Another thing, says Rashi, the type of food that the Yidden eat, it's universal for all Jews. All Jews, there is one type of dish that everybody eats. Whereas, Lefisha Hagayim, whereas by other nations, says Rashi, this nation worships this idol, the other nation worships another idol, there is no one God. And, Umachalei Shelzeh, Loikamachalei Shelzeh. And if you live in that place, you're eating this type of food. You live in another place, you eat a different type. There is no common denominator between all the Goyim. And that fact, that the Yidden serve one Hashem, and the Yidden have one dish that you find by everywhere, Mizgairim Shem. They decide they're going to convert because the Achdus that you find amongst all the Yidden. Very interesting. There are certain foods that wherever you grew up, the Yiddish mishpacha eats them. Some say that the Yiddish food that's universal, that's eaten by all homes, is the kugel. Kugel on Shabbos. It's such a special thing, the kugel on Shabbos, that the Kamarna Rebbe, in his Sefer Shulchan Ator, Simen Kuf Ayin Vav Seif Gimel, says to eat kugel on Shabbos is so special, so important. The words that he uses is, anybody who lives in our country and is not eating kugel on Shabbos, you got to check if something's wrong. The Jewish Michael is the kugel. Now, what does the word kugel mean? Kugel. What kind of word is that? So, I found some right. Kugel really is a Hebrew word, ki'igel. Ki'igel means, or kegel, means round. And usually the shape of the kugel was round. Others say that it's a remez, that the word kugel could be spelled chaf gimel lamed. Chaf gimel lamed, with a vav, is a Rashi Tevis for hu kizera gad lavan, which is what it says about the mun that didn't fall on Shabbos, and this is a sort of the replacement of the mun. Now, what your choice of what your favorite kugel may be, it's whatever your family tradition is. There are many interesting reasons why some people eat lakshin kugel, because we know that to struggle a whole week and work hard to make a parnasa is difficult. As Chazal say, kashin mizaynosef shel adam, that kriyas yamsuf, that to work and make a parnasa is almost as difficult as splitting of the yamsuf. Kashin. On Shabbos, it's like kashin. It's not hard. Hashem takes care of us. And that's why some have a remez to eat lakshin kugel, loikashin. Today things are more relaxed. It's Hashem's bill covering today's meal. Others eat apple kugel, potato kugel, each his own. The reason I want to speak about a specific Shabbos is when the Shabbos, as mentioned, there's a Michael that's designated specifically, other Michael we don't have during the week. So we also have during the week, so you can't tell how it's special for Shabbos. One or two Michalim we designate for Shabbos, it becomes a Shabbos type of food. It's mikaved einig Shabbos. It's so special that there's a story that the Belz Rebbe, the Aaron Mibelz, after he came out of the Holocaust, at one time he met Rabbi Issa Zalman Meltzer. Rabbi Issa Zalman Meltzer, after the Second World War, and obviously the Belz Rebbe was a real lost in the Rachman Eltzlan, he lost a big part of his family. And Rabbi Issa Zalman Meltzer asked him, how did you manage to survive? How was it surviving during those terrible times? And remember, the Belz Rebbe, Nebach, lost a lot of his family, and he had real tough times. And the Belz Rebbe paused for a second and turned to Rabbi Issa Zalman Meltzer with a smile and with a pleasant face, and he said, Chabaruch Hashem gahat yedin Shabbos kugel. Thank God that every Shabbos during the bad times I managed to eat kugel on Shabbos. Now that's a Shabbos dick of food, kugel. When their Shabbos has an additional guest, like Shabbos Reish Chodesh, now we have an issue. We want to show the additional guest. And sometimes you have Shabbos, Reish Chodesh, Chanukah. So there's two more guests come. So it's actually brought, in Magen Avraham and Hilchos Reish Chodesh, that when Shabbos and Reish Chodesh meet on the same Shabbos, you should make an extra pashtida, extra kugel, something special for the Shabbos, something special for this holiday. And there's a joke, Milstein the Bezichus said that we find that the Chernobyl and Magid once came for Shabbos to somebody's house, and he stayed, and it was a very simple person, and he saw that in that house, they're baking. He says, what's going on? He says that they're making kugel for Shabbos. He says, wow, you're baking so many kugels. Are you expecting a big crowd? So he says, no, it's only our family. But for our family, we make 24 kugels. See, the Chernobyl Maggid says, what's the 24 kugels? She says, because you know, in the Hoidu Lashem Ki Toiv, Ki Leilam Chastai. Yoimin Yisrael, Ki Leilam Chastai. So to correspond, the 24 Ki Leilam Chastai is for every one, we make a kugel. So the Maggid says, excuse me, you didn't count right. Amongst the Ki Leilam Chastai, there are 26. You should be making 26 kugels. So he says, huh? There is La'oig Melech Melech Amayri, La'oig Melech Boshan. You think for them I'm going to make a kugel? For a special occasion, we make a kugel, and the kugel is designated for a Michael for Shabbos, and that is actually part of the covenant, the mitzvah of covenant in the Shabbos, how we show, we honor and respect Shabbos.